are just great people, and I had a lot of fun just kind of living through them this whole tournament, really the whole season, because they're just such great gentlemen. I mean, we had no attitudes to deal with, no off ice issues. I always say you've got a great team when they're low maintenance. Everybody accepted their role, embraced their role, cheered each other on. Nobody was really at the forefront of our team, even though we had guys like Victor Stahlberg as a Hobie Baker finalist. He's as modest as they come. So I guess the memories I'll have is just what a great family we were able to create this year. And I think we got the most out of our team. And that's, as a coach, you're able to look back and enjoy the process. You know, we can enjoy this this journey because they did everything we asked, and they did it to their best of their ability. Fortune was just one or two goals shy. Adam, in the back.
Coach Adam Oden, College Hockey News. We talked a lot about how your team can play offensive now more so than when you first took over, and that use that to your advantage to come back in this game. But similar to perhaps the UNH series earlier this year, is your team just not comfortable playing that style at this point still in the program?
Well, you know, as I said, I think we needed to play better defensively. I mean, we got in the hole, you know, right off the bat. We just didn't play well in the first period. Our defensemen didn't move the puck very well. We had a lot of turnovers at the offensive blue line. I just think they were a much stronger team out of the gate. So we had to take some chances. We had to open things up a little bit. And we really just talked about in between periods, you know, just making simpler plays, getting the puck out of the zone, especially in neutral zone. And the second period was all quick decisions by our defensemen. We counterattacked very, very well. And I think we had some puck luck there as well. I don't think Milan gives up those goals too often. But again, I thought we stole back the momentum in the second period. I don't know what it was. I think that penalty kill was a good sign for us in the third period when we were up a goal. They've got a tremendous power play, and I was really pleased with how we killed that one. And we just made a couple of defensive mistakes, one on a two-on-two play that, you know, just shouldn't have happened. And then off the face-off, we just lost our assignment. You know, they're such a good team that you just can't give them an inch. And I don't think it's a matter of us being uncomfortable or not. It's just, again, we needed to be a little bit better defensively. Center.
Coach Elliot Olshansky, New York Daily News. What do you say for a game like this does for Hockey East as a conference to teams like you guys and BU going back and forth in prime time on national television, putting on the kind of show you did tonight?
Yeah, I think you're right, Elliot. I think it was a great college hockey game, you know, and I'm sure the people at ESPN were pleased with the product that was put out there. I think for Hockey East, you had two great programs going toe-to-toe, and I think it was great for college hockey in general, obviously selfishly for our league and for our two programs. You know, it was great for a lot of people and all over the country to see that kind of hockey. It was a great game.
Front row left.
Coach, there was a play, it looked like, I was hoping you could talk about it a little bit. There was a play where you guys put a shot on, and it looked like a Boston University player. The only thing that stopped the puck, because it beat Milan, the only thing that stopped the puck was a stick getting it down, and the play transitioned quickly into a Boston University goal. Can you talk about that play and you know, what you guys were feeling on the bench or what you saw?
Was that, what period was that in? First period, right? Was that their second
yeah,
goal?
Yeah, the second.
Yeah, we actually had two really good scoring chances. Roll off on the, you know, we got by Gilroy there on the breakaway. And I know it was, went to replay. We knew it didn't go in, but puck just got underneath him, and I don't think he knew where it went. You know, that's a game of inches there. And then I think it was, I think we actually hit the crossbar on that play, didn't we? It's right near the scramble in front of the net. Jack Downey tried to get it upstairs and hit the crossbar, and then they came down, went the other way. So, it's a game of inches, and unfortunately, the pucks weren't bouncing for us early, but I thought second period we got some puck luck back on our side. Again, that makes for a great college hockey game when there's momentum swings. Center, second row.
Coach Joseph White with the AP. Want to give us an early handicap on Boston versus Miami in the final?
Should be another great college hockey game. You know, Rico's done a great job with the Miami team. They've got some really dynamic forwards. Their defensive core has played well. Again, I think BU's the team to beat. You know, they're in my opinion, they're the best team in the country and have been that way for most of the year. So, but as Jack will tell his team, that doesn't mean much going into a one-game finale. Obviously, I want to wish both teams much success. Rico's a great coach, a good friend of mine, and Jack Parker's a legend, legendary coach, and has done such a great job with that team this year. So, you know, hopefully, just be a great college hockey game for the fans to enjoy. We'll take two more questions. First in the back.
Coach Malhurst, WPTZ. What do you say to a kid like Drew McKenzie? I mean, to experience that kind of high and then immediately followed by that kind of low. I mean, it'd be messed up for anybody, but for a freshman to deal with that kind of stuff, that's a lot to process. What do you say to him, kind of balancing him out heading into the offseason?
Well, you know, I think that's part of the game. You know, it's a game of mistakes, and we made our fair share of mistakes tonight, but we wouldn't have been in that situation without him having the poise to put that puck in the net in the first place on the power play. You know, it's a learning experience. You know, he's a freshman, and he's going to be a tremendous player for us. We love him. And again, he'll be able to put that away pretty quickly. He's a mentally tough young man, and he's had such a great season for us. I mean, there's a guy who came back from mono, you know, second half of the season. He was down and out for quite a while and built himself back up to be one of our better defensemen. So we're still very proud of his efforts, and you know, he'll be able to drop that pretty quickly. Okay, last question in the center.
Mike McHugh, WCAX coach. In your opening statement, you said you had a taste of it. Mm-hmm. The seniors, this is their last game, but for yourself and for everyone coming back, once the sting settles a little bit, how much is getting this close to the national championship game going to drive you guys in the offseason heading into next year?
Well, these are all great experiences for our student-athletes to have, and you know, you can't buy that experience, so we're hoping that this is the first of many for the guys in the locker room. Obviously tough for the seniors because they'll never have that opportunity again, but we really wouldn't be I wouldn't be sitting here talking to you without our seniors. You know, they were tremendous leaders, made my job very, very easy this year because they handled majority of any issues in terms of accountability on our team. So it's the hardest for them. You know, to take off that jersey tonight was not very easy for Dean Strong. And, you know, he gave a great post-game speech to the team after I addressed the team that, you know, our guys won't ever forget.
Thanks very much, Kevin.
Okay. Thanks, everyone.